Hello. Today I'm going to continue a series on some of my favorite ornamental trees. And today I'm going to talk about the paperbark maple, which is just behind me. Now, this one is an ornamental tree that's known primarily for its exfoliating bark. And what exfoliating means is it tends to peel off. And it originated in China, and it is an endangered species over there, but it's not a landscape tree that you see very often. I think there are probably two or three that I've seen in the area, and all of those have been on the campus of Michigan State University, except what I have here on my property. I really think people are missing out on this in the sense that it's a smaller tree, what we would normally say medium size. It gets to be about 30 feet tall. It's a medium growing tree in terms of its rate, so it takes quite a while for it to get that way. And this particular tree is probably about 25 feet tall now, and it's been here since about 1992, 93, somewhere along in there. So it's been here for quite a while. It's a very uncommon tree in the landscape because it's a difficult tree to propagate. Very few seeds will germinate, and it doesn't propagate well through cuttings. So that's one of the reasons why we don't see it. During the summer months, the leaves develop a slight bluish tinge to them, which turns brown to reddish as we get into the fall, depending on what type of fall that we have. And it also has a very nice interest because of the exfoliating bark. When snow sits on the branches, it is a stunning specimen tree in the landscape. In terms of growing this tree, it prefers full sunlight, but it can grow in partial shade. And what we mean by partial shade, we're talking about 4 to 6 hours a day of direct sunlight. It's hardy in zones 5 to 8, so it doesn't have any real problems here in Michigan in terms of cold weather. Mine has done very well. And it likes moist to well-drained soils. Those are kind of ideal. They will also grow on clay soils. I mentioned earlier that this tree had a medium growth rate, and actually it's more of a slow growth rate. It'll grow about 6 to 12 inches per year over a 10 to 15 year period. So if you're worried about this tree growing and filling in an area very quickly, it won't, which can work in your advantage also. If the tree is growing fairly near the street where it's subjected to salt sprays, it is moderately tolerant to salt in the soils. It's also drought tolerant and will tolerate poorly drained soils. That doesn't mean it should be sitting in water, but if it's, say you get some heavy rain and you have some standing water for a while, the tree will do fine. The shape of the tree is more oval in shape, and there are there's at least one upright version of this, and it does transplant well and can always be counted on as a place where robins like to nest. The upright version of this tree is called Fireburst, and it grows to be about 18 feet wide. It's a narrow upright form, and in the fall it will have the red color, and of course it does have the exfoliating bark also. One of the things you want to do with this tree when you're going to do some pruning, try to avoid spring pruning. You can wait till summer or fall or even during the dormant season, because it will produce and lose a lot of sap when you prune it in the spring when the sap is just beginning to flow. This tree doesn't have very many problems associated with it. I've had no diseases of any kind that have affected it, and also I've seen no insects feed on it. So from a standpoint of needing to treat it for pest problems, you don't have to worry about this one. Also, it does have these wing seeds called samaras, like most maples. And a lot of people would be concerned about that, because a Norway maple, if it drops a lot of those seeds, you'll have little trees coming up all over the place. This is not the case with this tree. In the 20 or more years that I've had this tree, I've only had 3 seedlings come up, and this particular species will produce hundreds of seeds every year. So you don't really have to worry about that, other than having to maybe clean them out of your gutters if your tree is too close to the house or on the grass. But other than that, it's a fairly problem-free tree. So check it out. I really love this one, and I would highly recommend it as a choice for your landscape. This is Gary. I'll see you later.